A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Today we study about discovery of proton, class 9, chapter number 2. As in previous lecture, we study about the discovery of proton, electron. Now, today we study about the discovery of proton. In 1886, Goldstein observed that in discharge tube, another type of rays are also present, which travel opposite direction to the cathode rays. Later on, these rays were named as canal rays or positive rays. For this, he performed another experiment. He used perforated cathode in discharge tube. Perforated means the cathode which have the holes in it. He observed that these rays travel in straight line and passes through the holes of the cathode. These rays were named as canal rays. Like cathode rays, there are also some properties of these rays. Number one, these rays travel in straight line opposite direction to the cathode surface. As we see here, these rays travel in straight line but opposite direction of the cathode rays. Similarly, these rays are positively charged. When in an electric and magnetic field, the deflection of these rays towards the negative plate indicated that these rays are negatively charged. Number three, nature of these rays depends upon the gas present in the discharge tube. But in previous lesson, in the discovery of cathode rays, we read that the nature of cathode rays is independent of the gas present in the discharge tube. But here, the nature of canal rays depend upon the gas present in the discharge tube. Number four, these rays are not originated from the anode. These rays are not originated from the anode. Actually, the question is arises, how these rays are originated? The answer of this question is that when the electrons present in the discharge tube, which we call the cathode rays, collide with the residual gas molecules present in the discharge tube, they ionize that gas molecules and the canal rays were produced. Number five, mass of these particles was found to equal to that of proton, and we know that mass of proton is 1840 times more than that of electron. That are the properties and characteristics of the canal rays. On the basis of these characteristics and properties, we concluded some results. Number one, these rays are made up of positive particles, which are known as canal rays. Number two, mass and charge of these positive particles depend upon the gas present in the discharge tube. It means different gases used in the discharge tube will have different masses of these particles. But keep in mind, positive particles produced by a gas will be of same type, mean canal rays. So this is the discovery of canal rays and some properties of and results of canal rays. So today's diary is canal rays. These rays also called positive rays. Learn by heart. Thank you.